Good day, everybody. Welcome to the radio show that has all of Santa Clarita on its feet, applauding. Not really, but it is a good radio show. We do talk about the real estate market, of course. Who am I? Well, I'm Connor McIver, Remax's Paris 911 team. Local agents, headquartered here in Santa Clarita Valley Cities. And for access to the show data for the numbers that I'm going to be spouting off, you can go to our main site, Paris, P-A-R-I-S, 911.com, and you can punch into the Mac box today's date in numeric form, 01072015. 01072015. As far as the show, real estate shows go, we're at 2015.007, and I'm, of course, your host. Today is our foreclosure update Wednesdays. We'll give a quick run-through into the market. Now, earlier this week, we did do a market updates broadcast. We also did, that was Monday, we also did a Travel Tuesdays broadcast. You want to see those shows, that information, use those numeric dates as well. 01052015 into the Mac box at paris911.com. And for the 6th, the same kind of a format. Now, so you know, we've taken all of our real estate shows, a lot of them, at least recently, and we've also done a dual upload. Besides them being on iTunes and Stitcher, we also do an additional upload into YouTube, so you're able to listen to those there. One picture usually with an intro video, maybe an outro video, but then you're able to see it. As far as what's in the news, a lot of talk about millennials purchasing real estate. Those are all of you out there that are listening, 19 to 35. In fact, a lot of the millennials that listen to our show, they're doing other things while they're listening to the show. So they're multitasking. They're not just sitting looking. In fact, a lot of the YouTube videos people don't even watch. They're just listening, especially if it's training or news related. Not a lot of importance to see pictures and some of those types of media, or some of those mediums, people talking about real estate and so on. But again, to get the added adventure, the added spin, you're more than welcome to go to our main site and punch in the date of the show you're listening to. All right, so the millennials, couple different things. As far as real estate goes, if you look at the overall real estate market, and this goes for anybody, just not millennials, one of the news programs I was listening to was talking about, for a millennial, you have to equate real estate with sex to get them to want to purchase it. If you look at real estate as an overall investment strategy, like from now on till the end, if you were to buy something in your 20s or mid-30s, carry that through the next 30, 40 years, you're going to be sitting real good as far as equity goes, for the most part, as long as nothing collapses and goes away. But that initial purchase, real estate typically has a great track record for increasing in value in the long run. So that's something, one thing to point out. Second thing, whenever you are trying to hire a service provider, and again, not just for millennials, goes for anybody, make sure that the person you're hiring, you sit in front of, and you get a feeling of who they are. Don't take them at face value when you're looking at them online, maybe like us listening to a real estate podcast or radio show, or watching our videos on YouTube. It's important that you meet with me. You meet with myself. We sit, we talk, we see if we click, and then we move on from there. I'm going to be in your life a while. So that's really important. So make sure, you know, you see people are going to loan you hundreds of thousands of dollars, but you're comfortable going with somebody that has an office that's 36 hours away in your car to get there, to confront them if something goes wrong. Be careful. There's your tip. Santa Clarita Real Estate Recap. We do have, are watching the market, last 7 days of activity. We do have 85 new real estate listings that have hit the market here in the SCV. 45 listings have had their price changed. Prices change. We'll see that more on Friday. 31 fell out of escrow. We have another 27 that jumped into escrow and backup status. 44 didn't sell during their contractual time frame, so those expired. And 16 real estate listings switched over from backup to pending. 72 closed escrow. Lots of happy people out there. Currently in Santa Clarita, 554 real estate listings that are in the active status. So if you look at active and backup, we have a total of 736, 182 being in backup. So add those two numbers, 554, 182. Should get 736. So that's the total active inventory. Looking on real estate syndication site this morning, they're showing 702. So more than likely, they're not getting that feed as quickly as we do because we're actual members of the MLS. You want to search like that. You want to see the Real Multiple Listing Service, main site, paris911.com. Click on the Home Search at the very top. You'll see it right there. Very simple. That's an actual MLS feed, data taken directly from the Board of Realtors, and that's where the syndication websites fall short. You'll be running into things that are fake, put on there just to get you to have some kind of a knee-jerk reaction. Maybe talk you into selling your place or talking you into buying one by the way that it skews the data and changes the actual way the system works and showing accurate properties. Foreclosures, well, we have those, about a dozen on the market currently in Santa Clarita Valley. What I did is I did post up foreclosure data page, so that'll give you an idea as to what those properties happen to be. In fact, when you punch in 0107-2015 into the Mac box, you'll get the article. In the article, I did put three different maps into a page that show the bank-owned inventory, foreclosure and REO stuff that's active on the market. And I did three maps, one showing just active, one showing just those in backup with an escrow, and the other one shows those that are pending with an escrow. And you're going to see it. It's all of Southern California. So it's a Google map interface. Double-click to zoom in, and then you'll be able to see closer views of any one of those properties. That's the current active. Now, there are some off-market things going on. As always, right? Always is. Even in a healthy market, you're talking about 1% of that healthy market being foreclosures. We're not there yet. We're still a little bit above that, but we're getting close. Getting close. So looking in Santa Clarita Valley, we are seeing that we have 287 distressed properties in some kind of process. So these properties are, in fact, made up of pre-foreclosures, properties going to auction, and bank-owned properties, including those that have been sold to a third at a trustee sale. So that's 287 Santa Clarita full. You'll see that map and you'll see that interface there, and you can even look at those properties moving over into zip code 91381 Stevenson Ranch. 30 total. It's calculated differently for Stevenson Ranch because they're kind of their standalone city. So whenever you're looking for real estate data, you want to make sure to have that included in some way, shape, or form. When we look at distressed real estate listings, that's what we do. So that's why we separated that out. And finally, where are we? Email question of the day, auctions. Can I buy one? How do I do it? Well, a great, great question came from Rob. And auctions, absolutely, you can buy one. Buy them all day long. They're a cash deal, Rob. So you have to be careful. Whenever you're approaching them, there has to be a lot of work done proceeding, giving up the ghost at an auction, giving up money. Maybe the house is occupied. Maybe it's not even there anymore. Maybe there are a whole bunch of liens equating to tens or hundreds of thousands of dollars that you're going to have to pay. So if that's the case, that auction might not be such a good deal. That's where that due diligence and homework comes in. So that's something you're going to have to look at. Whenever you are approaching properties at auctions, make sure you're working with somebody who knows what they're doing. And it is very labor intensive. Typical premium could be 6 to 10% plus the listing. If you're working with a professional that's going to do all that due diligence, there are some guarantees there. So be careful. Be careful, Rob. And absolutely, buy them all day long. And that's how the process works. I did go into more detail there. As far as real estate tips, again, you want to make sure that before hiring any service provider, you meet with them face to face. Tomorrow's show, we're going to be getting into Truth in Lending Thursdays. We're going to be talking about the market. We're going to be talking about a couple different loan programs. One with a 15-year lock might make you happy. I'm Connor McIver, over and out.